Good morning, my dear students. So in this class I am going to tell you about what are the terms we are going to use while solving the problems and also the different types of damping system. Okay, so normally I told number of times in the previous PPT also, damping is nothing but what? It is a resistance of a body to the motion of a vibrating body or a particular system is called as damping. Okay, or there is a reduction of amplitude is also called as damping system. Okay, so here so we are going to use three terms while solving the problems in damping system. Okay, so first term is called as a damped natural frequency. Okay, it is denoted by capital omega into d. Okay, capital omega suffix that is d. Okay, that is called as a damped natural frequency. Okay, so it indicates what the frequency of a damped vibration is called as a damped natural frequency. Okay, so normally the definition is, it is also very important. Sometimes they may ask you in the examination. Okay, what do you mean by damped natural frequency? Okay, so it is denoted by omega d and it indicates the frequency of a damped vibration. Okay, the free vibration of a particular system that is denoted by this damped natural frequency is called as damped natural frequency. Okay, normally it is denoted by omega into, that is omega d, and is given by the formula is what, omega d is equal to square root of 1 minus zeta square into omega n. So this is very important formula. Omega d is damped natural frequency, omega n is normally natural frequency. Okay, omega, and the formula is omega d is equal to square root of 1 minus zeta square into omega n. Okay, omega n formula is omega n is equal to square root of k by m. Okay, so the value of omega d is always less than omega n. Okay, you remember this while solving the problem. We want to get this with this condition we are going to satisfy while solving the problem. Okay, omega d is less than omega n. Omega d is a damped natural frequency, omega n is natural frequency. Okay, so remember this. So this is about the what a damped natural frequency. Okay, so now the second term is critical damped coefficient. Okay, that is normally denoted by cc. So this is also very important term while solving the problem. So normally capital C is indicate what, damping. C suffix C is indicate what, critical damping. C is coefficient. Okay, so it is defined as the value of damping coefficient C for which the radial sign in the below equation is equal to 0 is called as critical damping coefficient. Or another definition we are going to call as the critical damping coefficient is the amount of damping required for a particular system to be critically damped is called as critical damped system. Okay, how it is normally denoted by C into C. Okay, so we know that the roots of the characteristics equation of a free damped system is what, S of 1 comma 2 is equal to minus c by 2m plus or minus square root of c by 2m whole square minus k by n. Okay, this is normally we know that the roots of this damped system is this is the equation. Okay, so the definition says the radical sign should be negative sign. Okay, therefore the take the inside the value c by 2m, that is the inside the square root values c by 2m whole square minus k by m is equal to 0. Okay, so here k by m you transfer that right hand side, you are going to get what, c by 2m whole square is equal to k by m. Okay, so here the square is there, just to square take that right hand side direction, you are going to get what, c by 2m whole square, c by 2m is equal to square root of k by n. Okay, we know that square root of k by m is what, omega n. Omega n is nothing but what, natural frequency. Okay, therefore c by 2m is equal to omega n, but at the critical damping the c is equal to cc, therefore wherever c is there just to substitute cc. Okay, so therefore cc divided by 2m into is equal to omega n. Okay, therefore cc is equal to 2m into omega n, give equation number 1. Or c is equal to, we can write, we know that omega n is equal to what, natural frequency. C is equal to 2m square root of k by m. Okay, so here 2, that you take the inside that m get going to get cancelled, just you put it inside that m, so that we are going to get what, root of m square k divided by m. Okay, so m get cancelled, c is equal to 2 square root of m k, that q equation number 2. So this is what the critical damp equation. Okay, so critical damp equation formula is given by cc is equal to 2m omega n or 2 square root of m into k. Okay, so this is about the critical damping equation. So from the equation 1 and 2 it is clear that the critical damping depends upon the mass and the stiffness and independent of the damping system. Okay, and it is denoted and it is a constant for the given system. So normally critical damping system is always constant. Okay, so this I hope you understand these two terms. Okay, one term is called as critical damping coefficient, that is cc, another one is damped natural frequency, that is omega d. Okay, both are very important. Okay, so third is damping factor or damping ratio or impact ratio. All these three terms are same. Okay, so normally we are going to call in almost all the book damping factor, but it is also called as a damping ratio and the impact ratio. Okay, so here it is defined as the ratio of actual damping quotient to the critical damping coefficient is called, of a particular given system is called as damping factor or damping ratio. Okay, so it is denoted by zeta, and it is given by zeta is equal to what, C divided by CC. Okay, so I will repeat this. Damping factor is defined as the ratio of damping to the critical damping of a given particular system is called as damping factor or damping system. Okay, therefore damping factor is equal to zeta is equal to C by CC. We know that, so just to going to just to analyze this equation. Okay, we know that CC is equal to 2m into omega n. Okay, so m is equal to what, CC by 2 into omega divided by CC divided by 2 into omega n. Okay, or omega n is equal to root k by m, or omega n square is equal to k by m. All equations are same. So give question number 1, but we know that the roots for the particular given system is s of 1 comma 2 is equal to minus c by 2m plus or minus square root of c by 2m whole square minus k by m. Okay, give question number 2. Put equation number 1 in equation number 2. That value you are going to put here, you are going to get what, s of 1 comma 2 is equal to minus c divided by 2 cc divided by 2 into omega n plus or minus square root of that, to just to substitute here, c, that c by 2 cc by 2 omega n minus omega n whole square. Okay, that 2 we are going to get cancelled. Okay, so the remaining is what, s of 1 comma 2 is equal to minus c into omega n divided by cc plus or minus square root of c into omega n whole square higher divided by cc minus omega n square. Okay, but we know that c by cc. Okay, just to substitute in that equation, you are going to get what, s of 1 comma 2 is equal to minus zeta plus or minus square root of zeta square minus 1 into omega n. So this is about the critical damping roots equation. Okay, now so you are going to take the one is plus one, another one is negative. Okay, so that is the roots for the critical damped system is s of 1 comma minus zeta plus or minus square root of zeta square minus 1 into omega n. Okay, give equation number 3. Okay, therefore the general solution for the critical damped system is equal to, we know that x is equal to c1 e to the power of s1 of t plus c2 e to the power of s2 of t, equation number 4. Okay, so put equation number 3 in equation number 4, you are going to get the final equation. Okay, that is x is equal to c1 e to the power of minus zeta plus square root of zeta square minus 1 into omega n into t plus c2 e to the power of 1 minus zeta minus square root of zeta square minus 1 omega n into that whole bracket into t. So this is the general solution for the critical damped system. Okay, where c1 and c2 are called constant and 1 and 2 are called as roots. Okay, okay, so this is about the just analyzing the equations. Okay, while solving the problem you are going to get this equation. Okay, so for how to select the damping factor. Okay, if the damping factor value zeta, it is very important to decide whether the particular system is whether the overdamped, underdamped, critical damped. Okay, I told overdamped means if the value is greater than 1, if value is less than 1 means we are going to call as underdamped system, if the value is equal to 1 means that is we are going to call particular system is critical damped system. Okay, so this is about the just three definitions we are going to use while solving the problem. Okay, so now I am going to tell you about the different types of damping system. Okay, normally damping is not three definitions, I told you. So first definition we are going to call, that is we can define anything. Okay, so damping is nothing but what, it is a resistance of a body to the motion of a vibrating body or particular system is called as damping. Or normally the damping function is, it is a dissipation of energy from in a vibrating structure is called as damping. That is I shown here, the reduction going to amplitude is going to be reduced. This is called as a damping. Okay, so we are going to use, there are four different types of damping system. Okay, first one is a viscous damping, that is the second one is a Coulomb or dry friction damping, fourth one is a material or solid or historic damping, last one is a magnetic damping. Okay, so these are the four different types of dampings we are going to use. Okay, and this is also a very important question for the point of examination. They may ask you what are the different types of damping which are used in a damping particular system. Okay, so first one is viscous damping is nothing but the dissipation of energy that due to the movement of the bodies in a fluid medium. Okay, is called as viscous damping. Okay, so the energy going to loss in the movement of the body in a fluid medium is called as viscous damping. Okay, as the name indicates that viscous means fluid. Okay, second one is Coulomb damping. Okay, so this also very important. Here the damping force is constant in the magnitude, but in the opposite direction to the motion of the vibrating body is called as Coulomb damping. Okay, so I will repeat here, the damping force is constant in the magnitude, but the opposite in direction to that particular motion of a body, a vibrating body, is called as Coulomb damping. Okay, so now it is caused by the friction between the rubbing surfaces. Okay, normally if two rubbing surfaces takes place, then there is a chance of producing a Coulomb damping. Okay, so here I told you here, so it is caused by the friction between the rubbing surfaces that are either dry or have insufficient lubrication is called as Coulomb damping. Okay, so here normally in this type of the force of the friction is always opposite to the direction of the velocity of the masses. Okay, okay, when the two dry surfaces are relative motion, the friction between the opposes to the motion. Okay, such type of vibrations are called as Coulomb damping. Okay, so this is about the Coulomb damping, and next one is structural or hysteresis damping. Okay, this is also very important. Okay, so here the damping causes by the friction between the internal planes that slips or slide as a material deforms is called as hysteresis. Okay, such type of vibration occur, that is called as structural or solid damping. Okay, so here this type of the damping is due to the internal friction or intermolecular friction of the molecule in a material, and the resistance offered by the elastic properties of the body. This type of during the internal, okay, so internal frictions opposed to the motion, such type of vibrations are called as structural damping or the solid or structural damping. Okay, so next one is a slip or okay, that structural damping is caused by the Coulomb friction at the structural joint. Okay, it depends upon the many factors such as the joint forces or the surface properties. Okay, so last one is, it is also called as a interficial. Okay, that is slip. Okay, that is called as a magnetic damping. Okay, so here the energy of motion is converted into heat by the way of electric eddy current induced in the either coil or aluminum plate, okay, attached to the oscillating object that passes between the poles of the magnet. Okay, where there is a vibration occur, that type of damping is called as magnetic damping. Okay, that is energy losses in the corner of the poles. Okay, so here the energy of the vibration is dissipated by the microscopic slip occurring between the connected members at their interface under the fluctuating loads is called as a interfacial damping. Okay, so this is also very important damping. Okay, so these are the different types of damping and terms we are going to use in damping system. Okay, so I will repeat here the three terms. This is very very important. Okay, so first one is here what I told you, omega d, that is a damped natural frequency and is given by square root of 1 minus zeta square into omega n. Second one is cc, that is critical damping. Okay, critical damping formula, we know that what cc is equal to what, 2m into omega n, and the damping factor, it is defined as the ratio of c by cc. Okay, where c is damping and cc is nothing but critical damp system. Okay, these three terms are very important, and different types of dampings are viscous damping, Coulomb damping, what next one is the interfacial damping, the hysteresis type damping, and magnetic damping. Okay, these are the four different types of damping systems we are going to use in damping system. Okay, I hope you understand this. Thank you.